Children, hello, how are you? Now again we are ready to see our interesting subject physics. In which physics, in the last module, we have seen a different type of plant, biogas plant. How we can produce gas, what are the utility, advantage and disadvantage we have seen. Now today, we are going to see another kind of energy, that is wind energy. That is wind energy. Dear children, I am going to see what do you mean by here wind energy. As you know, this is a chapter of total theoretical chapter. So we have to remember it. Different sources of energy. What is wind energy? That is the motion of air. The motion of air along, motion of air along the surface of the earth, along the surface of the earth, surface of the earth, along the surface of the earth is called wind. Is called wind. It is clear? And short moving air, even I can say, is called wind. Is that clear? Now, a wind with a velocity of say around 3 meter per second से लेकर के अगर 5 meter per second तक का wind है, it is very weak and can only shake the small branch of tree that is not useful to us. The speed of this wind is not useful to us. Then, sir, what we do? Dear children, a wind with a velocity of around 13 meter per second to 15 meter per second. If this velocity is there, it is a strong wind and it is able to affect a person while he is walking. So this velocity we may use here. So, dear children, solar energy is one of the main factors responsible for movement of air. So, solar energy is the important factor for the movement of air in the atmosphere, that will formation of, you can say, wind. So, the kinetic energy possessed by the air due to its velocity is called wind energy. Is called wind energy. So write down the definition here. The kinetic energy possessed by the air due to its velocity. Due to its velocity is called wind energy. Dear children, we know very well, I explained earlier, renewable sources of energy. The wind energy is an example of, sir, it is an example of renewable source of energy. The wind energy is a renewable source of energy. It can be utilized for performing mechanical work, electrical work. We can use it. So now I am going to see how the windmill works. So we are going to see here windmill. For that we have to see how it will construct, what is the principle, how it works. The windmill, what is that? Windmill is a machine, we can say. Windmill is a machine. Windmill is a machine which converts the kinetic energy of the wind. Which converts the kinetic energy of the wind. Kinetic energy of the wind, that is wind energy into mechanical or electrical energy. Wind energy converts into mechanical energy or electrical energy. It is a one mark question. If asked in CBSE examination, so you may write. Is that clear? So dear children, a windmill resembles a large electric fan which is erected at some height on a rigid support. Say this is a rigid support and here is a fan. So just I am going to draw the diagram of windmill. Just you see here, first I am going to draw a diagram and then explain it. Here is suppose an axis is there on which, see here like this, a blade here is a blade, a wind is coming in this manner, here is the wind which rotates. The rotor blades, these are called rotor blades. These rotor blades are connected to this horizontal axis and here is a generator or dynamo, we can say. Here is a generator, here is a generator, here is a blade, here is an axis. It is on a rigid support. Here is our rigid support, or we can say it is our tower on which generator is fitted and connected to this blade. And here you can see the two wire coming out, that is say positive and negative. So we can say here it's a transmission line by which electricity is going on. Here is a transmission line, dear children, here is a generator and here is a tower. Draw this figure of windmill. Then I am going to explain what are the different parts and how it works. So windmill resembles a large electric fan, you can say, which is erected at some height on a rigid support. Here is our rigid support. The number of blades and their shape and their height of the windmill depend on the average wind velocity. How much velocity, in which area we are going to install the windmill, and what is the principle and working of windmill. What is the principle and working? Here is a very simple project. You can make it at your home also. You take a blade, connect with a motor, and you can generate an electricity. Take a small bulb, LED is there, then easily you can generate electricity and see the experiment. So design of the blades of a windmill is such that the pressure difference is created between its different region when the wind strikes them. Here and here, upper end and the lower end, the pressure difference generates due to wind. Then what happened? The pressure difference produces a turning effect. So due to pressure difference in the upper and lower side, so due to the pressure difference produces a turning effect. Produces a turning effect. Produces a turning effect and makes the blades rotate along this axis and makes the blade rotates this will rotate. Blade will rotate like this here. What the speed say? When the blade rotates about this horizontal axis, here is our horizontal axis. This is an horizontal axis here. Along this axis it rotates, and the rotational motion of the blade is then utilized to perform useful mechanical work or to generate electricity. So this is the principle and working of this machine. A windmill. What are the use of windmill? The windmill can be used first. Okay, what are the uses of windmill? First, for pumping water. In desert area where the rotational motion of the windmill is utilized to do the mechanical work, to operate a water lifting pump. This is the main use by the farmers for pumping water. Second one is to generate electricity. The second use of windmill, where the rotational motion of the windmill is used to rotate the armature of the generator. Such an arrangement is called wind turbine generator. This arrangement is called wind turbine generator that will produce electricity. Is that clear? So this is the use of windmills. So dear children, in desert area we can see a wind energy farmhouse. Wind energy farm. What is that? Wind energy farm. Wind energy farm. Where a large number of windmills are there, that is called wind energy farm. The electric power output of a single windmill is quite small. अगर एक ही windmill आप लगाएंगे तो उसका power output is very quite small. That is not useful and can't be used for commercial purposes. So what we have to do? We have to do, dear, a large number of windmills you can see are erected over a large area. So I can say a cluster of windmill जहां पर लाखों में सॉरी जहां पर हजारों की संख्या में विंडमिल हो. द क्लस्टर ऑफ विंडमिल इज कॉल्ड विंड एनर्जी फार्म. इट इज क्लियर? सो द कंबाइंड एनर्जी आउटपुट ऑफ द विंड एनर्जी या विंडमिल जनरेट्स इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विच इज यूज्ड ऑन कॉमर्शियल स्केल. इज दैट क्लियर? सो दिस इज द यूज ऑफ दिस. सो द मेन रिक्वायरमेंट for a wind farm are a site. What is your site where the wind blows constantly and form a consistent direction. Barabar hawa chalti rehti hai, aisa nahi hai ki subah subah chali fir ruk gayi fir chali aur fir ruk gayi. No, we can't generate constant energy, constant electricity. So we require constant wind. So such as we can say a mountain passes or taken such a site where the constant wind is there, then we can build up a wind energy farm. Is it clear? So leading users of wind energy farmhouse are available in Germany, USA, Denmark, in our India also. What are the merits of the wind energy? We can say the merits of the wind energy is a non-polluting. First, write down, it is non-polluting and environmental friendly source of energy. It is a renewable source of energy. It is a renewable source of energy and sustainable source of energy. Is that clear? So these are the special merits of this. But what are the limitations of the wind energy? The limitation of the wind energy farm can be located only in a vast open area. Open area must be there, a wind is constant, wind must be there. Is that clear? So open area located in favorable wind condition and the velocity of a wind is near about 15 km per hour at least, then we can generate electricity. So these are the limitations here. The cost of construction of a wind energy farm house initially it is very high. The cost initially it is very high. So remember it. Is that clear? In our India, the largest wind energy farm established in Kanyakumari at Tamil Nadu. Is it clear? So dear children, just to show the merits and demerits of windmills, now we see another type of energy, that is solar energy. Solar energy. The energy comes from sun, free of heat. Free heat ki jo energy hai, which we are getting continuously from last so many years. That is solar energy. The sun is a source of enormous energy. Even I can say it is a fusion reactor at a distance of 150 × 10⁶ km. From the earth. Is it clear? The energy from the sun in the form of radiation, the energy from the sun, in the form of radiation is called solar energy. Is called solar energy. Write down. So the energy from the sun in the form of radiation. It is clear? The sun is radiating energy at the rate of around 4.5 × 10⁷ kilojoule per second. See there, such an interesting phenomena of sun. It is clear? Sun radiates energy in all direction in space. The energy of sun covers a lot of area, a large area covering by the sun. It is clear? So we can say, dear children, what are the advantages of solar energy? It is available in abundance and that to without cost. सबसे बड़ी बात यह है, without cost. No बिजली का बिल इसमें कुछ भी नहीं लगता है. It is without cost. It is pollution free. It is pollution free. It is clear? These are the advantages. What are the limitations? बारिश के दिनों में कोई काम का नहीं है हमारी. It is not evenly distributed on the earth and becomes unavailable when the sky is covered. When the sky is covered with the cloud, then it is not useful. And a lot of costly equipment and infrastructure are required to put solar energy for practical use. So initial investment is very high. Initial investment is high. It is clear? So these are the limitations here. Then what do we mean by solar constant? What is solar constant? Now ये क्या होता है सर सोलार कॉन्स्टेंट? आई एम गोइंग टू डिफाइन द सोलार एनर्जी दैट स्ट्राइक्स द टॉप सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ एटमोस्फियर. सपोज दिस इज द अर्थ, ये इज द टॉप सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ एटमोस्फियर, इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर ऑल प्रैक्टिकल पर्पजेस एंड इट इज नोन एज सोलार कॉन्स्टेंट. वॉट आई एम टेलिंग, राइट डाउन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू राइट. द सोलार एनर्जी दैट स्ट्राइक्स, द सोलार एनर्जी दैट स्ट्राइक द टॉप सरफेस ऑफ द दैट स्ट्राइक्स ऑन द टॉप सरफेस, ऑन द टॉप सरफेस ऑफ अर्थ एटमोस्फियर, टॉप सरफेस ऑफ अर्थ एटमोस्फियर इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए कॉन्स्टेंट, इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर ऑल प्रैक्टिकल पर्पजेस, फॉर ऑल प्रैक्टिकल पर्पजेस, ऑल प्रैक्टिकल पर्पजेस इज नोन एज सोलार कॉन्स्टेंट. स्टिल डियर चिल्ड्रन, वी डोंट नो वॉट इज द एग्जैक्ट वैल्यू ऑफ सोलार कॉन्स्टेंट ड्यू टू डिफिकल्टीज इन टेकिंग एक्यूरेट मेजरमेंट. तो आई कैन से और आई कैन डिफाइन ए सोलार कॉन्स्टेंट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ सोलार रेडिएशन. इन फिजिक्स आई कैन एक्सप्लेन लाइक दिस, a solar constant is the amount of solar radiation, it is the amount of solar radiation, amount of solar radiation incident normally, incident normally, incident normally per second on, incident normally per second on 1 meter square area of a perfectly black surface, of a perfectly black surface, perfectly black surface at the mean distance of the earth, at the mean distance, at the mean distance of the earth, at the mean distance of the earth, at the mean distance of the earth from the sun, from the sun. This is solar constant. So again I am repeating dear children, it is the amount of solar radiation incident normally per second on 1 meter square area of a perfectly black surface at the mean distance of the earth from the sun. So we can say dear children, solar energy received must be equal to solar constant into time into area. This is the formula here. Write down, the solar constant or solar energy received, solar energy received, if you want to calculate solar energy received, that is equal to solar constant into area into time. That is by which you can calculate the solar energy. The approximate value of solar constant is 1.4 kilojoule. The approximate value of solar constant is around 1.4 kilojoule per second per square meter, per second per square meter, पर सेकेंड पर स्क्वायर मीटर। तो डियर चिल्ड्रन, सोलर कॉन्स्टेंट इज नॉट ए कॉन्स्टेंट इन द स्ट्रिक्ट सेंस ऑफ वर्ड। इट इज नॉट ए कॉन्स्टेंट लाइक दैट ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल कॉन्स्टेंट और स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन वैक्यूम। इज दैट क्लियर? तो डियर चिल्ड्रन, इवन ऑन ए क्लाउडलेस डे, जब क्लाउडलेस डे होता है, जब क्लाउड नहीं होते हैं, तो इन ए क्लाउडलेस डे द वैल्यू ऑफ सोलर कॉन्स्टेंट ऑन द अर्थ इज लेस बिकॉज द ओजोन इन द अपर एटमोस्फियर एब्जॉर्ब मच ऑफ द अल्ट्रावायलेट रेडिएशन। इज इट क्लियर? सम इंटरेस्टिंग फिनोमेना अबाउट दिस, तो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इट नाउ। तो यू राइट डाउन व्हाट इज दिस। Now we are going to discuss various solar energy devices. Solar energy devices. Just today I will introduce about this, and in the next module we have to see solar cookers, different type of solar cookers, solar cells. So what is solar energy device? Solar energy has been used since prehistoric times. From last so many years, we are using solar energy. But, dear children, still some research and development was carried out in a few countries how to use solar energy more efficiently. Is it clear? In our India also research is going on continuously, but most of the work was only used for academic interest. So dear children, the amount of solar energy that strikes the periphery of the earth atmosphere is around 1.4 kilowatt per meter square, as I told you earlier. This is the solar energy touches to the earth surface. So the important thing is for to collecting the solar energy in the form of heat, to collecting the solar energy in the form of heat and using this heat as such. So the device based on this principle are, we have to see solar cooker, solar water heater, solar geyser. So solar cooker we have to see in the next module. These device collect solar energy in the form of heat. Solar cooker, I can say it is a device that is collect the solar energy in the form of heat for a period of 5 to 7 hours. For a period of 5 to 7 hours during a sunny day. Also, converting solar energy into electricity. The second use of this, what is that? That is solar energy converting into electricity, and this device based on this principle that is called solar cell. We have to see later on. So device which either uses solar energy directly as a heat and converts it into electricity is called solar energy device. Am I right? I am going to write the definition. What is solar energy device? The device, a device which either uses, solar energy directly. Either uses solar energy directly. Either uses solar energy directly as a heat, or converts it into electricity. Converts it into electricity. एज ए हीट और कन्वर्ट्स इट इनटू इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज कॉल्ड सोलार एनर्जी डिवाइस। डियर चिल्ड्रन, इन आवर नेक्स्ट मॉड्यूल वी हैव टू सी सोलार कुकर, सोलार सेल। इज दैट क्लियर? राइट डाउन। ओके,